Today topic is lagging, leading and unity power factor. This is simple circuit. This is AC supply. This is resistive load. Voltage across this load is V and current flowing is I. This is wave shape of voltage. This is wave shape of current. This side voltage, this side time. This side current, this side time. Now in this voltage wave shape you see, at this point voltage is crossing from minus to plus. At this point it is crossing from plus to minus. So we will consider this point where voltage is crossing from negative to positive. This wave shape has many zero crossing points. This also, this also, this also. Where voltage is going from minus to plus, we will consider this. Similarly in current, voltage crossing is this. Now in case of resistance, angle between this point and this point is always zero. And power factor is equal to cos phi. If phi is zero, cos zero will be equal to 1. So in case of resistive load, power factor is 1 because angle between this zero crossing and this zero crossing is 0 and cos 0 is 1. Now here there was only resistive load. If I connect one more load, inductor, then current here will increase because there are two currents. One more thing will happen, this current will shift right side like this. If I put some more load, inductive load, then current will shift further right. Now you see here, this is voltage crossing, this is current zero crossing. Angle between these two is 45 degrees. This angle is called phase angle. And if we put this 45 degree here, we get cos 45 is equal to 0.7. So at this point, power factor is 0.7 lagging, lag. Why lag or lagging? Suppose we start from here, then first voltage crossing will come. Then current crossing will come. So current crossing is lagging or coming afterward. When current is lagging, power factor also will be lagging. Now suppose we remove this resistor, only inductor is there. In that case, this will shift further and it will come at 90 degree. Now angle between zero crossing of voltage and current is 90 degree. And if you put 90 here, cos 90 will come zero. So power factor is zero here. Now here again load is resistive, so both are matching zero crossing at the same time. Suppose we put a capacitor here. In case of inductor, this current was shifting right side, but in the case of capacitor, current will shift left side. If we put some more capacitor, then this current will shift further left. Now here, angle between this zero crossing and this zero crossing is 45 degree. So cos 45 is 0.7, so power factor is 0.7, but leading. Why leading? This is because current is leading. If you start from here, current will come first, zero crossing will come first, and voltage zero crossing will come later. So current is leading. So power factor is leading. Now suppose we remove the resistor, then current will shift further and zero crossing time difference or angle difference will be 90 degree. Voltage zero crossing here, current zero crossing here, and 90 degree if you put here, cos 90 will be zero. So power factor will be again zero. Here R and L both loads are there and current is lagging by 45 degree. I told earlier, because of inductor, current moves right side, and because of capacitor, which is not here, it will move left side. Now, if you want to reduce this angle, then we have to put a capacitor. Now, if you put capacitor here, then this current will shift left side again. So, angle between this and this will come down, and this power factor will improve. Lower the angle, better the power factor. Now here, current zero crossing, voltage zero crossing is matching. If I put inductor here, it will shift. If I put pure inductor here, it will go to 90 degree here, lagging. And if it is pure capacitor, I told just now, it will go like this. So this zero crossing of current will shift from here to here, like this, depending upon here resistor is there, inductor is there, or capacitor is there. This side lagging power factor, this side leading power factor. Just now I told power factor is cos phi, where phi is the angle between zero crossing of voltage and current. This is one method of finding power factor. Another method is using power diagram. So there are two methods. One, using this angle between zero crossing of voltage and current, and second one is using power diagram, where this is power flowing in the resistor, this is power flowing in inductor, and this is total power here. If R and L is there, then power factor, power diagram will be like this. If capacitor is here, then diagram will be like this. And if pure resistor is there, then diagram will be like this. Angle between P and S will be zero. This angle, and this angle between these two zero crossing all are same. Today we will close here itself.